Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is about the Sephora VIB sale that's coming up this weekend when this video is being released. I believe there's going to be two weekends where you can shop the VIB sale. I mean, depending on your status, it'll be the Rouge sale, VIB, or Beauty Insider sale. But it starts this weekend, the 26th of April, and I believe that it is going to be two consecutive weekends in a row. As some of you may know, if you've watched my channel before, I am a Sephora employee. I work there, and I'm used to selling Sephora products on a daily basis. I know Sephora is a pricey place to go to. They barely ever have sales, so when there is a sale, I suggest that you guys stock up on as much as you can because this is the best deal that you're going to be able to get on these products, hands down. Usually, luxury makeup products don't go on sale too often, so I have a huge range of things sitting in front of me right here. These are some of my top Sephora products. As some of you may know, I have dry skin, but I am adding in products that are going to work for oily skin as well. So I'm going to show you a bunch of products that work for like all different skin types, and then if there's products that I'm suggesting that are better for like normal combination and dry skin, I am going to also suggest an alternative in case you're very, very oily. Before we get started with this huge list of things, make sure you guys give the video a thumbs up if you enjoy it. If you're new here, my name is Patty, and I would love it if you hit the red subscribe button down below for more videos like this and tutorials and all the fun stuff. If you have any comments, make sure to leave them in the comment section down below. I am still really good at replying to all my comments, so if you have anything to tell me, just go ahead and let me know there. Let's not make this intro too long, let's just go ahead and get started. Alright guys, so first things first, I am not saying that anybody needs all of these products that I'm about to show you or talk to you guys about. Just think strategically, what have you been wanting from Sephora? And what are you in need of like restocking on? What have you been eyeing for a little while? This is the moment to get it. I'm going to start with some skincare suggestions and I'll move on to makeup from there. I also want to say that because I have so many recommendations, I am not going to talk about every product in detail. I have talked about most of these products in previous videos anyway. So if you guys are wondering what I think of any of these products or how I use them, look back at my other videos and you're going to see a lot of them being featured on there. And I am going to leave a list of everything I talk about in the description box down below. I barely ever do that, but I have so many products in front of me. I want to give you guys some kind of guide, I guess. I don't know. I hope it's helpful. Let's just go ahead and get started. So first things first, toner. This is the first thing I do every morning is I tone my face. I have two suggestions for toners. The one I'm currently using is this one here. This is the Dark Spot Toner by Ole Henriksen. I love this stuff. It has glycolic acid in it, which helps me exfoliate. Besides this one, my other suggestion is going to be the Caudalie Toner. I'm going to insert a picture right here because I don't own that one currently, but I've used it in the past and I absolutely love it. So those are your two toner options. I apply my toners with cotton, and this is the best cotton. This never goes on sale. This is from Shiseido. It's $12 cotton, but you're not going to regret buying it, especially if you're getting 15 or 20% off of it. So Shiseido cotton, it is the best. If you're going to be using more pricey skincare, you don't want your skincare to get soaked up on your cotton, and this cotton will help you deliver the product to your face rather than it going to waste, basically. Continuing on with skincare, I have this right here. This is the Kiehl's Midnight Recovery Concentrate. I use this every night before I go to bed underneath my moisturizer, and it is really nice and nourishing for your skin. I feel like it's really helped me out, especially with hydration. In the morning, I use this right here. This is the Face Hero Oil. The brand is called Go-To. I absolutely love this. It is a bunch of oils mixed together that give me the most like radiance and hydration, and I have been obsessing over it so much that I'm currently out of it. I ran out, and I have been using the CEO Glow instead of this one now. And this one is also a really, really nice one. This one has vitamin C and it has turmeric, and I've been using it as my serum in the morning underneath the moisturizer. Usually you do oils over the moisturizer as your final step, but these specific ones that I'm talking about have treatment in them, so I put them on underneath the moisturizer. They're also dry oil, so they sink right into the skin. If you are super oily, I'm not recommending an oil for you. You might want to look look into a serum that is anti-aging or exfoliating or anything like that. For moisturizer, I have three that I'm going to show you that I absolutely love. My favorite moisturizer of all time is this one here. This right here is the Dr. Dennis Gross C+ Collagen Moisturizer. I love that it's lightweight but extremely hydrating. It's got vitamin C and collagen in the formula. This is the best moisturizer at Sephora, hands down. If you are oily, you might not be able to use that one. I do have a recommendation for you coming up, but my second recommendation is this here. This is a CEO moisturizer by Sunday Riley, also has vitamin C in it. I really love that one, and it kind of helps cover your pores a little bit, so you can use it as a primer during the day. And then my third recommendation is this right here. Summertime is coming and you guys need to guard your skin against sun damage. This moisturizer right here is my favorite one that has SPF in it. This is a Perfect World from Origin. This has SPF of 40 in it and it is really nice. If you have very oily skin, I would probably try Tidal by Sunday Riley. It is an amazing moisturizer for oily skin. Or the Peptide Moisturizer from Drunk Elephant. I love those for oilier skin. For eye cream, I absolutely love these. These are both from Fresh. This is the Rose Hydrating Eye Cream. I use this one during the day, this one for nighttime. This is the black tea one. Check out Fresh's eye creams. They are amazing. If you have very oily skin, even underneath your eyes, and you don't want a nourishing eye cream, Autocorrect from Sunday Riley is amazing. I should have talked about makeup melters and cleansers before, but we're just gonna do it now. I have two makeup melters that I absolutely love. The first one being the Pharmacy Take the Day Off, I think it's called. I'm gonna put a picture right here so you guys can see it. I think that is the best makeup melter I've ever tried, because I use makeup melters as my first step in my cleansing routine at night, and I always double cleanse, but with that specific one, I don't feel like I have to, because it leaves my face that clean. So I absolutely love that Pharmacy one. Another one that you guys can try is this one here. This is from Drunk Elephant. I love that it has a little booster in it so that you can exfoliate with. This is called the Slay Makeup Melting Butter Cleanser, and this one's been really, really nice and nourishing for my face. So I also recommend it. I feel like with that one, I always feel the need for a double cleanse though, because it leaves a little bit of a film on my face. Some people think that it feels more hydrating because it feels that way when you rinse it off, but I just feel like I need to rinse it off further. I don't know if that makes sense. It is my second favorite makeup melter nonetheless, because the other ones I've tried I don't love as much as those do. For cleansers, I have three right here that I want to quickly touch on. If you have very oily skin, I would try Ceramic Slit by Sunday Riley. This one is good for all skin types pretty much and is a pretty nice cleanser. These are the two that I have on rotation right now for me in my dry skin. The Soy Face Cleanser from Fresh, I'm sure you guys have heard about this before. Amazing, amazing cleanser. This is good for pretty much all skin types. And this right here is something that I feel like never gets mentioned anywhere, and I love it. I don't love to use it the way that they recommend to use it, because you're supposed to use it with like dry hands, dry skin, and kind of like a makeup melter. And it is a honey cleanser, so it's kind of sticky. I don't like that. What I do is I use it as my second step. As you can see, it's down to here. I've used a lot of it. So right after I'm done melting my makeup away, my face is wet, my hands are wet because I just rinsed some makeup off of my face. So right then I use this one, a couple pumps will do you. I make it kind of like foam up in between my hands, and then I go to my face and put it on. And I absolutely love it. I feel like it leaves my face so squeaky clean. And I recently learned that it has salicylic acid in it. So if you are acne prone but dry, girl, you need this. It has salicylic acid, so it'll help you against breakouts. One last thing for skincare. These right here are some of my favorite masks, the Origins masks. I've been obsessing over Hello Calm. This has CBD oil in it. It is very calming for the skin. You can use a little bit of it and leave it on at nighttime too. Clear Improvement, great for like cleaning out your pores. really nice. And if you suffer with skin texture, I would definitely try this one. This is Origins Retexturizing Clay Mask, and it is fantastic. Besides those, the Baby Facial by Drunk Elephant is amazing, and Fresh masks are also to die for, so I would also check those out. I'm done with the skincare section of this. Let's just go ahead and jump right into the makeup. For primer, this right here is my recommendation. This is the Milk Hydro Grip Primer. If you have normal, combination, or dry skin, you're going to like this guy right here a lot. If you have oily skin, I would probably try the Cover FX Mattifying Primer. That one's also nice because it's got 1% salicylic acid, so it'll help you with breakouts. But everybody else, this one is to die for. I have two foundations that I'm recommending to you, and this is the time to splurge on the luxury items because, again, they never go on sale. So I'm not holding back from all my favorite pricey stuff. And you guys know I've been talking nonstop about this right here. This is the YSL Touche Éclat All-in-One Glow Tinted Moisturizer. You guys need to try this. It is so bomb. Gives you perfect glowy medium coverage. Absolutely recommend it. For foundation, I am still not over my Beauty Blender Bounce Foundation. This works for pretty much all skin types. You can be very oily and love it, and you can be very dry like myself and also love it. So I definitely recommend that you try it. It is a beautiful, buildable coverage. Obviously, I recommend that you buy a beauty blender, because when else are you gonna get a beauty blender 15 or 20% off? You need to restock on your beauty blenders right now during the sale. And for concealers, I have my two favorite ones right here, and they're also from YSL. If you have combination, normal, or oily skin, you're going to love the All Hours Concealer by YSL. It is amazing, soft matte finish, very thin. It does not enhance texture at all. If you have normal or dry skin, you are also going to love this one here. This is the Touche Éclat Full Cover Concealer from YSL. It is their newest concealer, and it is absolutely beautiful. I am wearing it every day. I have been wearing it every day since I got it, and it is so freaking stunning, and it looks flawless, and it has an amazing amount of coverage. For setting powders, I have three different ones to show you guys, and then I have a recommendation for oilier skin. So if you have normal to dry skin but you still like to set your face, I love these right here. This is the Huda Beauty setting powder. I use mine in the color Pound Cake, which is a very light yellowy tone. I love this one because it's very finely milded and it makes my makeup not crease. My latest obsession for setting powder though has been the Hourglass one, and I love this one because it is not a matte finish and it gives your skin a very skin-like effect, and it's perfect if you have dry skin. If you are into pressed setting powders because you take it with you on the go, Charlotte Tilbury, it's where it's at. This airbrush compact powder from Charlotte Tilbury is amazing, and it gives your skin the best blur. Now, these three are going to be awesome if you have anything but extremely oily skin. If your skin is extremely oily, then I would probably do either the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder or the Fenty Setting Powder. I had to return my Fenty one because it was drying me out so much, but if you have oily skin, you're going to absolutely love that one. Let's move on to bronzers. I have two bronzers that I recommend during the sale. These right here, nothing new and exciting, but beautiful bronzers nevertheless. I have the Anastasia one in the color Rosewood, and I love this one. Or good old Hoola bronzer is amazing. So I would absolutely recommend that you guys try some of those or restock on some of those if you need to. For blushes, I'm not going that fancy because I actually love Sephora Collection blushes. So these right here are some of my favorite colors. I have Shame On You, which is my all-time favorite color. That's what I'm wearing right now. And I also have Flirted Up, which is a bit more peachy. And then, of course, NARS blushes are an all-time favorite. You can try NARS Orgasm, Amour, Deep Throat. All of those are really beautiful, stunning blushes that I recommend. And we have gotten to the highlighter section of this video, and I have three highlighters here that I love. I would recommend Anastasia Amrisi, but I think it's pretty much sold out everywhere, so I don't think you'll be able to get your hands on that one. So besides that one, of course, Champagne Pop by Becca is still a beautiful classic. I absolutely love it. my new found love right here. This is the Lancome Monochromatic Eclats Glow. That is what I'm wearing today again. And I love that it melts into your skin like butter and it gives you a very skin-like glowy look. And then I also love this right here from Stila. This is the Heaven's Dew Glimmer Highlighter in Silver Lake. This stuff is amazing. For brows, I have one recommendation only and it is this right here. This is the Brow Blade for Urban Decay. I hate that this is $26, but I love it so much. I can't recommend anything but this one. And if you're getting 15 or 20% off of it, it is definitely worth splurging on it. For eyeshadow primer, if you're looking for a new one, I really like the Makeup Forever Eyes and Lips Primer. It's really nice. And for lips, I have a little selection here that I want to share with you guys. I definitely recommend trying the Charlotte Tilbury lip liners. This one is in Pillow Talk and I absolutely loved it, as well as the Charlotte Tilbury matte lipsticks. This one here is also Pillow Talk. I have been obsessing over it since I tried it a couple videos ago. And then this right here, if you're able to get your hands on it, this is a NARS lip oil in Orgasm. This stuff feels like a lip balm. It's so hydrating. It has a beautiful tint in it. It lasts for a very long time. It's magic. If it's been sold out at my store, so I don't know if it's like that everywhere, but if you can get your hands on this one, I definitely would try it. And then my other two lip recommendations are once again from YSL. I love the Tatouage lipsticks from YSL. This is my one in number 25, which is the one I'm wearing right now. I absolutely love this formula and how comfortable they feel. And then of course the Rouge Volupté Shine Lipsticks by YSL are so freaking stunning and amazing and comfortable to wear and hydrating. So if you can get your hands on some of those, if you've been eyeing it for a little while, just go ahead and do it, girl. Let's talk about eyeshadows. First off, if you've been eyeing any palette at all, this is the moment to get them because they're all going to be on sale. I have a few recommendations. If you have been wanting a Natasha Denona palette real bad, I would go ahead and buy it now that it's on sale. I can't get myself to purchase those because I feel like they're still kind of expensive, but if you've been wanting one really bad, I would definitely buy it. Besides that, Huda Beauty palettes, you are gonna also be able to get them on sale. These are $65, so a 15 or 20% off of these is going to be really nice. Anastasia palettes are usually 44 or 45, I think. This is the Riviera palette, which is what I'm wearing on my eyes right here. Definitely recommend this one or any other Anastasia palette you've been eyeing. Now is the time to get it. And then of course the Born to Run palette by Urban Decay. It is really nice to get this one with a little deal. I believe this one's normally 48, so 20% off of that would be really nice if you've been wanting this one as well. For eyeliner, my favorite one is the Stila Stay All Day Liquid Eyeliner if you're looking for a liquid. And if you're looking for a pencil, I would definitely go for the Marc Jacobs pencil eyeliners. I absolutely love those two. Mascaras, I have three that I'm recommending to you guys. The Shock Mascara by YSL and the Hourglass Caution are my top two favorite mascaras. They're each $29, so to get them with a little discount is very nice. My number one favorite mascara is the Shock, so I would definitely recommend that. If you are concerned about your lashes looking a little clumpy, then the one you need is the YSL Caution Mascara. And if $29 with a discount is still a little pricey, then go for the Marc Jacobs Velvet Noir. This one is $26 regularly, so it's a few dollars cheaper and it gives you just as much drama as the Shock Mascara by YSL. Those are my top three mascara picks. For setting spray, I would definitely do the All Nighter. You can do the regular one or the Pollution Protection one. I love this one because it's nice to have all the protection you can get. And then finally, the last thing is some brushes. So these here are some of my favorite Sephora collection brushes that I reach for so much. Definitely recommend them. I'm gonna grab this one because I use this one on a daily basis too. Eye brushes, you need the Sephora collection number 13, the number 12, the number 18, the number 15, and the number 27. Those are must-have Sephora collection eye brushes. And then for the face, I cannot live without my number 79. This is what I set my under eyes with every single day of my life, and I've had it for 3 years, and it is amazing. perfect size brush for under eye. They advertise it as a contour brush, but I use it for setting my under eyes and it's wonderful. Whew. Okay, that is it. That is all of my products that I am recommending to you guys. I tried to spit them out as quickly as I could. I'm sorry if this was a bit overwhelming. Again, in the description box of this video, you're going to find the list of everything. I'm going to divide them by categories for you. So think about what you want and venture out into the Sephora VIB sale. If you have a Sephora near you, I would definitely recommend that you go to your local Sephora and try to shop for your list of things. Support your local Sephora store. A lot of big retailers have been closing and people are always surprised, but like, were you shopping there or were you shopping online? I know that Sephora really tries to make your experience as smooth and seamless as possible. And in the store you can play and swatch and try and talk about makeup with a makeup consultant, which is always a very nice thing to do. So I definitely recommend that you go to a store instead of buying everything online, but that's because my paycheck depends on it. So I'm kind of a little biased in that aspect. Obviously all of these are available online as well, but you can always feel textures and swatch colors and play with makeup at Sephora, which is really nice. If you guys like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, leave me any comments or any questions in the comments down below. And if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe before you leave, please. 90-something% of people who watch my videos are not subscribed and it makes me so sad. So go ahead and hit that red subscribe button and help me reach 10,000 subscribers. We are getting close to the 10,000 subscriber mark and I'm so freaking excited about it. I have nothing else to tell you guys. I hope you like these recommendations. Thank you so much as always for watching my video and I hope to see you back in the next one. Bye!